happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys, Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video on Dakota Plains. So, we are gonna finish up this rye field here in this video. I do need to do some testing off camera on a different save game. I was told by a guy that was also playing on here that his soybeans weren't working like they should be, so I need to do an off-camera separate save game test to see if it works on here or not. And if not, then we will just do a different crop. I did do another change here. I fixed the attacher joint on this tractor, although for this planter it seems really low. Change the sounds on it. I did not edit the map yet. That'll be the next thing. And then I also did one other thing. Got us a new pickup. Just swapped it out. This is a 2015 Ford F-250, deluxe version, I'll say. It's got the fuel tank in the back, which is not functional yet. The creator does plan, he wants to script it, so that way you can fill it in here. And it's got a custom headache rack, bed liner, or bed sides, whatever you want to call it. So, nice new truck. So now we are all set for our equipment. So the only thing that I have left to edit is the map. Just edit that gate, and I think we're all set. Of course, I don't know what the deal is with the soybeans and whatnot. So, yeah. I do need to go in and finish working on these tractors, get the fan animated, see if I can get these needles animated. I don't know how the guy has them set up, if the guy has them all as one piece, because if so, then they're just going to have to stay the way that they are, because I'm not taking this thing back into Blender and redoing those needles to make them so that they can, they move. Just to get a gold standard on FSUK. But I will get the fan animated because I'm pretty sure that is centered. So that'll be pretty easy to animate. And the steering wheel's already animated. So just need to get the fan belt animated. Check to see if I can animate those needles. And then fix the error that this thing throws, which is just a little thing. I just need to change the location of the dirt normal PNG file, and then it'll be all set, and I'll re-upload to FSUK. If they're not happy with those needles not working, if they're all one piece, then that's fine. It'll just be a silver standard mod, but silver standard is good enough. That's what the original was as well, so that's what this can be too. Because I'm not putting it back into Blender to separate those needles out and center them so that they rotate and all that stuff. That's just not happening. Not happening at all. We're almost done with the field of rye here, and then we can put some sunflowers in the ground. And, moving along with planting pretty fast, which is good. The planter that I want to get next is this guy right here. I would say the sunflower, but for some reason it only plants like one crop, or maybe this one, but this one I want to redo. I just haven't yet. I want to put it back into Blender, do a little bit of work to the model, give it nice AO textures, make it, you know, script, and then re-script it so that way it's not using the scripting from this and just having parts of this thing invisible, and get these the row markers working and all that stuff. And then, but I need to figure out what the deal is with the sunflower. Maybe there's just a little thing in the XML where it's, you know, it doesn't have any other crops added. It only has like wheat or barley or whatever added. So need to go in and add those other crops. So I'll have to, when I do the testing, I'll have to buy that planter and just switch through some stuff and see if it'll allow me to plant anything else. Good, it did pick that up. Well, I was not sure if it was going to or not. Oh, another thing I did edit on the Alice pack is I forgot to add dirt to the stack on it. I noticed that when I was moving the attacher joint. So I went in and changed that so that it works. I did start the timer, good. And I did edit that, so now that works as well. So I think now we've got all the equipment and whatnot that we need now. Didn't really need that truck that I put in here, but I kind of like it a lot better than the Chevy. I mean, it is a new truck compared to, you know, a lot of our equipment right now, but it's just, I really like it. It's a nice truck. So, come on, autosave. I want to be able to clean this little spot up. So today is actually only Tuesday. It is the day after the second episode of this went up. I'm just, you know, I've got this entire past week, you know, the week of the 13th through 19th, I've got videos recorded, edited, and uploaded and ready to rock. So I'm just gonna record a whole nother week's worth, I guess. Then I wouldn't have to worry about videos for a while, but I'll probably, of course, just continue recording and be a, you know, long ways ahead, which wouldn't bother me any. Better to be ahead than way behind. So if I can be a week worth of videos a week ahead, so, you know, have like 2 weeks of videos all ready to rock, that'd just be awesome. Okay, so now for this field, so we need to change over to sunflower, We need to rotate this 90 degrees here. Let's see, where do we want to start about? I'll say right about here. How about that? Looks pretty good. Actually, we'll go one more here, I think. One more, call it good. Get planter straightened out here. Or even crookeder. Get even more off of where I wanted it. That's not what I wanted. That was the wrong button. Holy smokes. The wrong button. I did not want to rotate that 90 degrees. I just wanted to bring it back up. This is a bit of a challenge for this guy. I like this planter model, I just wish that it kind of was a little better. Like, mainly just the way that these wheels run and stuff. Because it does kind of get annoying with the way that they work now. So while that's going on, I'm going to erase all the stuff from this current week and get it ready for the next. Okay, so we're gonna kind of stop a little before where I need to. Oh, it's actually about perfect right there. Anyway, we're gonna rotate this 90 degrees now. And I don't want to move it any, because I want to be able to follow the same path that I was just on. We are planting a little bit into the grass, but that's alright, because we are cleaning up. You know, you can see there is some grass on top of the field, so we are getting that cleaned up as well. So we'll do three headlands here. Yeah, I know I don't own that field, because that's the next field over. Evidently, we have some field boundary issues here. Maybe we'll have enough seed in this planter to plant all of this sunflower ground without having to refill. That'd be nice. Save some money, save some time of having to run back to the farm. Well, of having to fold this planter up, run back to the farm, refill it, come back to the field, unfold it, and then plant again. which is another reason why, like, that, whatever that, you know, one other odd planter, that's why that one would really be nice, because it's, well, that one's actually even wider, so the sunflower planter would be the best thing, but I don't think any of our tractors currently can handle it. I'd have to look at what, like, the horsepower requirements are on it, see if any of these old monsters can run it. Okay, so now we're gonna flip that again, and then we'll do these, do a pass down this edge here. Really? Ah. Well, that kind of is annoying. Well, I guess what we'll do here is we'll just drive over here and we'll just keep going up and down and plant wherever it'll let us. That's kind of annoying. Oh well. Whatever. I thought if you did it on your own, you could plant. Even on fields that you didn't own or something like that, but I guess not. I don't know why I thought that, but I did. Man, and we're only halfway through the video. We finished the rye and have like a fair amount of the sunflowers done too. We're moving right along here. So we probably got, I'll say, two or three videos of planting left, and then probably two or three videos of spraying, and then we'll be able to harvest. So if we can't put soybeans in, we'll just put some corn in, and we'll just combine some corn. Corn I don't think is worth quite that much. Yeah, so like $460, but, or maybe we could put some oats in. Let's see, what other crops does this show? That's it. Okay. I guess we'll kind of see what happens. Kind of go with the flow. Okay, so we're gonna go down here and we're gonna see, we're gonna go as far over as GPS goes here to the edge of this field. We'll kind of see how this ends up here. Alright, so this is gonna work out great. Of course, if this planter would want to cooperate, it'd be even greater. No such luck on that. So we're gonna do a pass here. And see what happens. See if we get any field boundary issues. I'm just going to mark down that this is recorded. planter is starting to slide a little. If this planter didn't like slide around all the time and, you know, drove a little better in transport mode, I'd really, really like it. I do really like it, but it's got its couple issues. I mean, guess nothing's perfect. Unless you do it yourself, really. A little gap in his cab here. In fact, quite a few gaps. Okay, so what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna work that way towards that field and just go over as far as I can. I am going to skip passes though, so, but I am going to plant all the way down, even if it, you know, like if I'm up here and it's saying, you know, you do not own this field, I'm just going to keep driving down, because you never know how far down it may go. It may go down to like kind of the edge of that field, or it may go all the way down, who knows, or it may stop like right up here. I mean, it's hard to say, so. You just gotta do the whole pass and see what happens. Getting rid of some more grass now. Heck, with as much as we're getting done in this video, there might only be like two videos more of planting, depending on how much it take, how many, you know, how long it takes to plant with the corn planter. Because I mean, we're gonna nearly finish this sunflower section in this video. I mean, we still got 7 minutes left, and we don't have a whole lot of ground left to cover. So if I could finish it all in this video, I might make this video just a little longer, just to be able to finish it in this video. So we should be getting close to our area of issues, I think. See, this wouldn't take so long, but that hill kind of kills the tractors, or this tractor at least. Takes a little bit longer to get up the hill. Okay, so we should be getting into some stuff here now on this pass. This is where I'm assuming it's gonna happen the most. Well, maybe not. Okay. Guess it's gonna let me plant. Hmm. What the world? That's kind of annoying. That's really annoying. It's kind of annoying that it's doing it and then now it's not. Gotta love farm sim physics, huh? Okay, so we'll see. Maybe it's just this little sliver here that it's not allowing us to plant. Who knows? Or maybe it's just gonna let me plant it. Yeah, it's gonna let me plant it. What the heck? Not an issue. What in the world? That's ridiculously annoying. I mean, ridiculously annoying. Anyhow, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and shut the timer off right now, and we're just gonna finish this. Might as well. Unplug that. Checking a message here. If it would load, there it is. I don't think we'll have enough seed to finish, though. Maybe I'll put down, like, a placeable pallet out here in the field area. That way I don't have to always go back to the farm. Just because it's kind of a pain with this planter. Or I could cut the video, run and edit the map quick. But I don't know. Maybe that's what I'll do. Because then this planter would fit like this. So I may do that. That's probably what I'll do, is just quick cut the video, run and, you know, hurry up and edit the map to take that out, and then come back again. There's probably only, I'm gonna say, 5 passes there, maybe. Maybe not even. So now that all this grass is going away from the edges, you can actually see where the real edge of this field is. Okay, so I'm gonna quick cut the video here. I'm gonna go run and edit the map, get rid of that fence thing, and then I'm going to finish up these little passes here that I'm working on now, and then I will be back. So I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, so we're back. I just did some editing. I'm going to go ahead and try it out. I didn't actually delete it. This is what I did. I just extended it, and then I removed the clip on it as well. So if there's something that, you know, this doesn't like, that it's thinking should or like it's not close enough to recognize or something, because there are machines that I've had that don't open gates, so if that happens, I can still just drive through. Not the most realistic way, but this truck's got some crazy brakes. Anyhow, let's get finished. I was actually spot on in saying five passes left, because literally there was five passes. There's four passes over there yet. So, we're going to try and roll through these quick. So we are going to run out of seed pretty quick. I don't know if we'll make it all of this. Let's see, because I think we had a little under 400 liters of seed. So, yeah, we're definitely not going to make it. It's going to be, like, so close that it's going to be so annoying when it doesn't. I wish we were bigger, because if this was a much bigger operation, I could get the Meridian or even a seed tender in general, but I really don't have a seed tender that kind of fits with this, because the only other seed tender that I have is the J&M's, and those just kind of don't fit. They don't really fit in. I don't think there's anything in tippers. Oh, we do have this. This would fit in. Holy crap, I just spent way too much money on that. Yikes. I didn't even look at the price. That was stupid. Oh well. I don't think I have any loan out. Oh, just the 200,000, so if needed, I can take out more. I don't know if this happens to anybody else, but if I eat something like hot, my nose starts running. While I was eating some Dots pretzels, and they're really not that hot, but after you eat like quite a few of them, then they kind of start, you can start to feel them. My nose starts running. So that's why I'm sniffly. Okay, well, while we're down on this end of the field, we're going to go ahead, we're going to go, no, that's why, it's not in a group yet. We're going to go ahead and we're going to run to town and go get, what? I thought I unhooked that. Dang it. We're going to go ahead and run to town and get our, trailer here. Of course, we gotta jump out and take a screenshot. Always got a screenshot. Especially a beauty like this. I know he did a stock version of this too, I think. Or it, like, it didn't have the big lift on it, it just had some normal tires. Or no, it had the lift, it just, it didn't have the these crazy tires. But I do have some tires, some wheels and rims that would look good on this thing. Whoa. Its handling gets very crazy at times. And it is really touchy with damage mod. Holy smokes. Yeah, like, if you let off the gas, it'll, like, damage itself. That's ridiculous. So we'll have to definitely drive a little slower going home. Say 35, maybe. We'll try that and see how it goes. Oh, I just got this cool idea. Something that'd be really cool to put on pickups is have two different hitches and make them selectable. Have, you know, this normal hitch here, but then also have another one for like farm trailers that, you know, it's got like the, you know, it's basically a hitch just without the ball, and just make it like you can select which one you want. That'd be cool. Hey, my last name's in there. That's kind of funny. J.M. Schwerkraftwagen. Wagen. I don't know. I'm just guessing here. Turn on our hazards. Good, I caught it when they were on. Oh, he didn't add them to the mirrors. Gotta add them to the mirrors. Pretty sure that's how these Fords are. Yeah. .35 seems like a good speed. Seems to work well. Maybe we'll bump it up to 40. This truck definitely has some speed to it. And the dial is about 20 miles off though. 20 mile an hour off. It's kind of funny. I think if it was that far off, you'd want to get it fixed. I'm not a huge fan of Fords, but I love how this truck turned out. This is not my build, by the way. This is the owner of Canadian Farming and Modding's build. It's a model that he purchased, and then he made a few things on it. I think the tank, and then like the headache rack and some other stuff on it, I think. I don't remember what he said. But I know he did some, you know, customization to it, you know, the wheels and whatnot. And Yeah, pretty nice, and it is color selectable. I bought a few different ones until I found the color that I liked the most. Then just put it on here in the same position as the Chevy was in. Basically, the way that you do that is you buy, you know, like me, I'll explain how I do it, I guess. I go on to Westbridge Hills. I buy the model that the mod that I want, and then if it's color selectable, I figure out which color I want, and then I save the game with only that, you know, well, not always only that, but, you know, like, I try and keep it limited with, like, only that version of that particular, you know, the truck in particular. And so that way I don't get them confused as to, oh, I bought the wrong truck, or I moved the wrong truck over. I wanted, you know, the blue, not the gold or whatever. So, you know, you just gotta make sure that you only have the one of the certain thing that you want. And then you just save your game, and then you go to your farm sim folder into the that's enough seed. You go into the vehicles XML in your save game folder, and you just copy all of the stuff, you know, for that vehicle, and then you go to your save game for, you know, whichever save game you're playing on. In this case, for me, it's save game 1. And then save game 7 is my Westbridge Hills save game for testing, you know, new stuff and whatever, or edits or whatever I'm testing. And then, you know, I just paste it underneath of the thing that I want to replace, make sure I get the vehicle ID number correct, and then I just copy the translations, you know, the XYZs for, you know, coordinates and rotation, and then it's good to go. And then I just delete, you know, the truck that I, or the thing that I'm replacing. And if you guys want, I can do a tutorial on that. Just let me know if you'd like me to do one. Just put it down in the comments, you know, say something, you know, like, yeah, I'd like to see a tutorial on, you know, moving stuff from one save game to another or something like that, you know, whatever. Or, you know, yeah, I'd like to see that tutorial you talked about or whatever. Oh, shoot. That was the wrong button. Again. Three more passes, and then the sunflowers are done. We'll split this right down the middle here. Because why not? You gotta be kidding me. I don't know why, but my SciTech stuff likes to do that. I'll hit the button, and it'll register for a second. And then it won't go through. So Monday. Had to take a look here at the video schedule in my trusty notebook. Evidently, I had paper bits in there. Okay. Put this on this piece of paper. So we just have one more downhill pass, or one more uphill pass, and then a downhill. And we're all set to go. We're all done with planting with this setup anyways. Well, for a second there, it looked like that wheel was like wobbling or something. That's kind of weird. Guess it was just the way I was looking at it. And depending on how the John Deere planter sits on that Alice Chalmers, we may actually need to use this tractor to plant with that. And then we could just switch, you know, run the Alice on this and then run this on the corn planter. Because with as low as that is set, I'm not sure how it's going to like that in the field. Because if you look here, it's pretty low to the ground. I mean, it's just about touching. So we might have to swap that around or something. I'm not sure yet. Oh, I didn't edit that yet. That's the other thing I need to go back and edit. So, okay. So we'll get this uphill pass done, and then get the downhill done, and we're all finished with the planting of sunflowers. So rye is done, sunflower will be done, and we just have the soybeans or corn, whichever. And I did look, actually, we could lease that field, although right now it would make us nearly broke. But we could actually lease field 30. So if soybeans do work, maybe we'll look into leasing that field for a season and putting corn on it, or more soybeans or sunflowers or something, or maybe some oats, whatever we decide to put down, and then but yeah, it's, I think it's like 4,000 to rent or to lease it. So it might be an option, but it would make us nearly broke. But the only thing, with that, all that we have left that we have to pay for is probably like one or two refills on that John Deere planter and then just the spray. So if we went in the red, it would maybe be like no more than, I'd say no more than 6,000 in the red. I'm just going that far down just because, you know, it could be maybe 3 or something. But I don't think it'd be too far in the red. And then having that extra field and that extra crop would also bring even more money come time to sell. So, you know, it'd be helpful in a way. But, you know, it would cause us to go in the red, but like I said, it wouldn't be too horrible, you know, it wouldn't be too terribly deep in the hole. So I'll probably, you know what, heck with it, we're gonna do it right here right now. Field management, field 30, where'd it go, field 30, yeah, $4,845 to lease. We'll lease it, we got 30 days left, so and we can plant it for a few growth seasons. Having that lease option is really nice though, because you can get your fields, you know, you can have them for 30 days at a much cheaper price, and you know, it's, you're not spending the huge amount to pay for it, but you know, you do have to pay constant lease on it every 30 days, but you know, whatever, it in the short go, it is helpful. In the long run, it's kind of you kind of waste more money on it in a way, just because, you know, if we just sit and lease that field all the time, you know, we could have that 50,000 in, you know, in a short amount of time, and then we'd buy it for 50, or even however much we spend on leasing the field, you know, it's, you've wasted that much more. But whatever, it's not about not about what's gonna happen, it's what's happening. I mean, we're just focusing on this right now. But yeah, guys, so I'm gonna get this thing taken back, and I'll do that testing of the soybeans and whatnot else, and figure out if we can plant soybeans or not. And then, depending on what I figure out, we'll put in some soybeans. Otherwise, we'll plant a whole bunch of corn and whatnot. So yeah, thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. Turn off GPS. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. I think I already said that, I don't know. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.